Good evening. This is News.PH, but it's not politics as usual. I'm Pia Hontiveros. One month since Mamasapano, and the questions linger, hanging, hovering over us like some dark cloud on a very dark day. It is human instinct then to try and find our way out of the dark and into the light. Our guest, Mohagher Iqbal, the chairman of the peace panel of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, that is trying not just to hammer out a peace agreement, but also to salvage it, to save it from dying a senseless death, much like the deaths of the 44 SAF commandos, the 18 MILF fighters, and civilians. Peace, after all, has been shattered and is now threatened by what happened in Mamasapano 31 days ago. Chairman Iqbal, maraming salamat for agreeing to do this interview. We appreciate it very much.
Maraming salamat din po.
Well, let's begin with this. Since we're taping today a few hours before the show, can you tell us what it was like getting stuck in traffic because of and on EDSA?
The urgency of this meeting, this interview, gives more reason for me really to catch up with the schedule. So I kahit na late din, pero nandito pa rin kami.
Oo. Di bale po, Chairman, late din po kami. Ako. Anyway, well, Chairman Iqbal, can you tell us, let's begin with this, no? Why won't you submit your report on the investigation into Mamasapano to the Philippine government first? Why submit it first to the Malaysian government?
Our peace engagement with the government of the Philippines is covered by protocols. And one of the provisions of those protocols is that there is third-party facilitation. In short, there is no direct engagement between government and MILF peace panels. It has to pass through the third-party facilitation. But right now, there is a little bit relaxation of the protocol because we are now partners. Unlike before, that we are talking across the negotiating table with each party positions. We have respective positions, and from those respective positions, we started to talk, we started to negotiate, and then finally, we agreed certain documents, so we signed it. But right now, that kind of protocol is relaxed, as I said. So there is more partnership between us and those.
There is more direct communication between the two
but
panels.
This kind of this document is really needed to pass through the Malaysian facilitator, because that's the protocol.
Bakit nga po, aside from the fact that there is protocol, that there is SOP because of the negotiations?
It's in protocol. The main reason is that nandun yun sa protocol na kailangan sundin namin, na yung mga official exchange of documents na kailangan yan, dadaan yan dun sa facilitator. And then from the facilitator, even if the document is addressed to my counterpart, eh, doon pa rin dadaan yan. And then to my counterpart in government, pag natanggap nila yung report, they can furnish. Yung halimbawa, yung Senado, lower house ng Congress ng Pilipinas.
But where is the investigation report right now? It is still with you, right?
It's not yet finished. So it's not yet finalized. But I think in few days from now, it would be finalized. But the problem is that before we can release that, it requires the presence of our chairman, and our chairman, Chairman Murad, is currently in the Middle East. He's performing a minor pilgrimage to Makkah.
When will he be back?
When will expectedly, during our last conversation with him, most probably he would be here next week.
Next week. So we can expect the report in about maybe 2 weeks' time.
There is an urgency really to come out with the report. Of course, we will not release the whole report. We will release the executive summary. Yun ang ibibigay po namin.
Okay. Chairman Iqbal, the firearms that were returned to the government, were, in so many words, unserviceable. No? There were many terms that were used to describe it. My question is, why was there a symbolic turnover in Mindanao if you were going to turn over the firearms that were unserviceable anyway?
No, actually, nung dumating yung armas, last February 18, nandun po kami with my counterpart sa Awang Airport, sa Kamsiong ko. Nung dalhin ng Sispar Committees ng Emalat Gobyerno ng Pilipinas, chinek po ng, I don't know if it was the military or...
It was the military po, because you were turning over to the AFP, not to the PNP.
Precisely, yes. Stand corrected. Uh-oh. At chinek nila yung, ano, yung serial numbers, eh, nagmamats naman. Sa kanalang namin nalaman, na meron daw na cannibalization of the the firearms siguro mga 2 or 3 days afterward. So although I'm not saying that hindi ho tama yon, I'm not saying that na yung ano yung PNP mukhang meron nangyari doon na hindi natin inaasahan, pero kahit na nagsasabi sila ng totoo, pero it is something na na-impute na hindi maganda sa MILF. Kaya, ang sa amin, kung talagang alamin natin kung ano pa talaga nangyari, dapat dadaan din yan sa third-party investigation. Oo. Kaya lang, wala na yun, nandun na, ano na yun, moot and academic na eh.
Oo. But are you saying, Chairman Iqbal, that when you turned over the firearms, they were in good condition?
Yes, I saw the firearms. I didn't touch them, but I saw them and all the serial numbers. As far as information is concerned, match each other.
Well, no, we're not talking about the serial numbers. Walang question po doon. Yung ang question po doon ay kung serviceable, na-cannibalize or something. Ang sinasabi po ninyo, buong-buo ang firearms nung binigay ninyo sa AFP. Eh bakit po ba hindi na lang sa PNP diretso binigay?
That's an internal arrangement on the part of government. They did not ask us that.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Because that way, at least, harap-harapan, pwedeng sabihin ng PNP, okay, correct, serial number. Pero meron po tayong problema dito. Yung, hindi po ba? Para wala nang problema.
But we did not question that. We leave that to the discretion of government. How we would turn over the firearms.
Chairman Iqbal, let's talk about that that video of the SAF commando who's lying on the ground being shot by the person who was holding the cell phone camera. And then afterwards, yung paglulut, no, yung pagkuha ng mga gamit. You described the man who shot that video and who shot the SAF commando as a criminal, correct, sir?
Yes.
That's how you describe him. If he is a criminal, then that means he violated a law.
Yes, human rights law.
Human rights law, yeah. Not our laws?
Well, probably, yes, because there is a legal system in the Philippines. But in the case of our engagement with government, we are covered by protocols. And we are bound by those protocols. And we will observe and abide by those protocols.
What do those protocols say about turning over someone who has violated the law?
No, I'm referring to the ceasefire agreement and terms of preference of the ad hoc joint action group. Alam naman natin yung adyeg ang trabaho po noon na ibinigay ng gobyerno ng Pilipinas sa MILF to isolate and interdict kidnap for ransom groups and other criminal gangs, including those commands operating in Mindanao. So yun po ang mekanismo na pag-address namin sa mga sitwasyon na may violation of ceasefire. So yun po ang magiging susundin po namin between government and MILF kasi yun ang ano yun ang mekanismo.
Oh, yun ang mekanismo. Pero so what does the mechanism tell us about how we will treat this particular person once he is identified? Will you turn him over? Ganun po ba yun? What how do
I
we
was
deal
asked
with this person?
The same question, but normally if there is a violation of the ceasefire, it's the ceasefire committee of the MILF and government that will handle the issue. But this one, if it is in the nature of a war crime, I said before the Senate hearing that the MILF is willing to turn that over to the International Court of Justice, although government is not happy about that, but that's how we see it.
Okay. Do you know his name? Do you know the name of this man?
Who?
The man in the video who shot the
No, we do not have the technology to know that.
Okay.
Except that what is very clearly shown in the video is the SAF commando who was lying practically dead.
So we have not identified the man who shot the SAF
commando. No, because only the hands are seen. Only the hands are seen in the video.
Yeah, but have you been able, your men in the field, have your men been able to question people on the ground in Mamasapano to ask who that man was?
As far as the MILF is concerned, our investigation showed that none in the MILF ranks did that, because our military code of conduct, which has been implemented since 2005, strictly prohibits that kind of savagery. That's savagery because in that military code of conduct, the MILF, it says that yung mga wounded na kalaban, quote-unquote, huwag na lang patayin kasi hindi pwede. Bawal yun
bawal
sa military contact ng MILF, but bawal din sa Islam yan.
Okay. Chairman Iqbal, how would you describe Mamasapano? Is it a special guerrilla enclave? This is how General Boogie Mendoza describes it. A special guerrilla enclave that has MILF, BIFF, other groups, including an NPA group. Ganun po ba yun? Is that what Mamasapano is?
Well, it's a community. At least apat ang mga nando doon, yung mga civilians, MILF, BIFF, at saka private army. It's a community.
It's a community of armed members.
A camp of the MILF, it's a community. And then, you know, in a community, you cannot compartmentalize the movements of people.
Okay. Is it a no man's land for Philippine soldiers and policemen?
Hindi naman
meaning
po.
If they go in and try to effect an arrest warrant, they will be shot on sight?
No, there has to be a mechanism for that. There should be prior coordination through the ADIAG, through the ceasefire committee of the MILF. So kailangan po mayroong coordination, prior coordination.
Kaya prior coordination.
Yun ang iniiwasan natin pag walang coordination. Talagang mangyari yung problema na ganyan. Alam nyo, since 2011 up to January 25, wala akong inkwentro. Yung sa Basilan sa Albarca, that was 2011. Pumasok kang Marines, wala rin coordination. Kaya nagkaroon ng bakbakan, 25 Marines na namatay. At pinugutan ng ulo ng mga Abu Sayyaf. So walang coordination po yun. Ito na ulit na naman, walang coordination doon. Kaya nangyari yung ganyan ng mga pangalan.
So dapat may coordination, dapat sabihin dapat ng ho, AFP
dapat
or ng BNP, may aarestuhin po kami sa loob ng Mamasapano. Ganun po yun? Dapat yun ang sabihin nila. They should tell the MILF, we need to arrest Marwan and Usman.
Because we have the mechanism. We have the ad hoc chain action group na magtulungan yung ADIAG ng gobyerno at ADIAG ng MILF. Then in tandem with the ceasefire committees of the MILF and government, they will do it all together.
Chairman Iqbal, you said that MILF members were not acting as one on January 25 and they were not acting as in parang may chain of command sila. Para bang nagkanya-kanyahan dahil nga nilusob ang kanilang community. At what other times and circumstances are MILF fighters allowed to go it alone? Na para bang walang order from the top, basta't bahala kayo.
Because we never expected that kind of situation. We never anticipated that the sub-commanders will enter that precise moment at around 4 o'clock. In the morning, the darkest part of the night. And we never expected that such kind of encounter will ever take place. Kaya, yung mga persa po namin, almost walang commander eh. Nagkakanya-kanya yun.
Okay. News.PH will be right back. Stay with us. Welcome back to News.PH. I'm Pia Hontiveros. Still with us, the chair of the MILF Peace Panel, Mohagher Iqbal. Chairman Iqbal, is Mamasapano also a haven for people like Marwan and Usman? I did not say that they were in MILF territory. The community as it was, as we described it earlier.
Alam mo, frankly speaking, we only confirm through our intelligence service that Marwan was there when it was already reported that he was dead.
When was that? Before?
That was... After January 25. Because we cannot confirm. Because alam po ninyo, yung nature ng crime ni Marwan at saka si Abdul Basit Usman, wala hong suporta sa taong bayan. So nagtatago yan. At saka yung mga pangalan nila, nagpapalit-palit sila. Halimbawa, si Marwan, ang pangalan Mads, Hulago, Lago, si Abdul Basit Usman, ang pangalan sa community, Teng. So no way for us to know that.
No way for you to know that, kahit na nandun siya sa isang community.
Kasi palipat-lipat po. Lalong-lalo na po si Marwan, 2012, na-report na po yan na namatay sa Sulu during a bombing spree ng aeroplano ng Pilipinas using smart bomb. And then pangalawa, nandun sa Lano de Sur, sinasabi, and then sinasabi after that, nandun sa Maguindanao. Alam niyo, si Marwan, tatlong asawa yan eh.
Mm-hmm.
Ang unang asawa niya, yung asawa ni Kadhafi Dianjalani.
Mm-hmm.
So, mamatay si Kadhafi Dianjalani, naging asawa niya yung asawa niya. At saka ang pangalawang asawa niya, kapatid na isang Abu Sayyaf Pumanis sa Sulu.
Mm-hmm.
So, mayroon pang pangatlong asawa, hindi lang napangalanan doon sa report ni Maria Ressa.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Chairman Iqbal, do you know, you meaning the MILF, do you know where Usman is hiding?
Ganun din po, palipat-lipat.
Ganun din.
Palipat-lipat.
Mm-hmm. Pero wala po siya sa Maguindanao?
Most likely, baka nasa vicinity na rin eh.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi wanda siya doon sa inkwento na yan eh.
Pero who is protecting him right now?
He has his own way to protect himself.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Not the BIFF.
I cannot say for certainty, but the area where Marwan was shut up is an area of the BIFF.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The BIFF, how do you describe them? What is your relationship between, what is the relationship between the BIFF?
BIFF is a separate organization, different agenda, different approaches. Hindi sila naniniwala sa usapang pangkapayapaan. Ang paniniwala nila, gera, ganun yun. Sa amin, naniniwala kami na the best way to solve the problem in Mindanao is to a negotiated political settlement. And nakipag-usap kami sa gobyerno ng Pilipinas.
Mm-hmm. Ang BIFF, when you say iba ang approach, meaning they were the ones who finished off the SAF commanders?
Well, I'm not saying that unless lalabas yung investigation na silang gumawa. Mm-hmm. Pero sa amin, ang nasisigurado ko sa iyo ay yung mga karumal-dumal na mga ginagawa, mahigpit po ang leadership ng MILF kasi meron po kami military code of conduct. At saka kami naniniwala sa Islam na bawal yung ganun.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But you are aware, Chairman, I suppose that there are analysts who believe that the BIFF is your dirty tricks department. Whose actions you can disavow anytime. You know that, right? That is how some people think.
I think that's a bad imputation because we've been dealing with the government with trust and confidence.
Mm-hmm.
At saka wala rin naman kami magkukuha kung halimbawa yung mga bagay na ganyan, karumal-dumal. Eh, wala rin kami magagawa, wala rin kami magkukuha diyan. Pangalawa, kung yung kilalalabasan ng mga sitwasyon na ganyan, pati kami, yung mga sibilan namin, na naghihirapan na rin, nagsasuffer na rin. So, in plain words, anong katuturan makukuha namin dyan? Wala.
What good will it do us?
Yeah, what good will we will get from that.
Okay. Does the MILF chairman have a weapons and munitions factory anywhere in Mindanao?
Before we have.
Before?
Yeah, but
until
now,
when?
I'm not too sure, but I cannot give the specific...
When you say before, meaning you shut it down?
We shut it down because, there is no sense building up our military hardware because as soon as the Bangsa Morovesic Law is passed in Congress, we are going to decommission our weapons and put them beyond use.
Okay. How did you shut down those weapons and munitions factory?
Sinira na yung mga, kasi may ginagamit yan ng mga machines, so sinisira yun.
Sinisira. Okay. Do you allow, well, I suppose you do not allow people in your ranks who make bombs, for example, like Marwan,
Usman. That's
prohibited. Prohibited, no?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. Do you allow people in your ranks who pledge allegiance to ISIS? No. Pledge allegiance to ISIS? No, definitely not.
No.
Because there is that...
The name by itself is already alien to us.
Mm-hmm.
Islamic State of Iraq and Syria. Malayo na po, nasa Middle East po yan.
Oh, okay. But you know, John Mendoza, again, I mentioned him earlier, he was saying that that man who was holding the cell phone camera and taking that video, they do that because, in so many words, parang yun ang audition tape nila for ISIS. Gusto nilang makarating sa ISIS yung pinaggagawa nila.
Ang problema ho, ay palagyan natin tao doon sa lugar na kumuha kasi nakita naman. Pero ang problema, yung bumaril nung wounded SAF commando at saka yung kumuha ng video, talaga sa akin, criminal yon. Pero ang nag-upload po, hindi Muslim, kundi isang negosyante na taga Kidapawan City at saka Davao City. Kaya doon sa Senado, medyo napagtalunan namin po sa isang senador, hindi ko na babanggitin ang pangalan. No?
Ba't ayaw niyo banggitin ang pangalan?
Para hindi magiging personal.
Uh-huh.
Sabi niya, legally, wala hong kasalanan yung tao nag-upload. Pero granting that legally, there is no kasalanan. But morally, I think it has something to do with morality. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga itinigil po na ipakita yung video ng sasinado dahil hindi ho maganda.
Mm-hmm. Okay. No one wants war, Chairman Iqbal. So what are you, the MILF, willing to give up for peace?
That's why ginagawa po namin ang lahat ng paraan para po maipasa yung Bangsa Moro Bisiklo. That's the only way forward to have peace in Mindanao.
Maipasa ang Bangsa Moro Bisiklo according to the schedule that had already been set out? Or are you willing to stretch things out a bit?
That's the ideal situation. Mm-hmm. It can be passed in accordance with the original schedule. That's the best scenario. Mm-hmm. But you know, there are situations that are beyond our control. So there is a saying that in the absence of what is best, what is available is always the best.
Mm-hmm. If the ARMM was a disappointment or a failed experiment, as some people would like to describe it, what guarantee can you give that the Bangsa Moro will not go the same way?
We'll give the best in ourselves. Mm-hmm. We will give the best in ourselves. And I hope with the guidance of our ideology, especially on accountability. Yung accountability kasi sa amin, hindi lang doon sa papeles, hindi lang sa tao. Kahit anong gagawin namin, nakikita kami lang doon sa taas. And that's the accountability we want to follow. Accountability before men and accountability before God.
Mm-hmm. My last question, Chairman Iqbal. You do not describe yourself as a Filipino, correct?
No, by citizenship, we are Filipinos.
Citizenship, Filipino.
By identity, we are Bangsa Moro.
Identity, Bangsa Moro. Meaning, the only time that we will see Filipino is on an identification card or on a passport where kung saan ang tinatanong ang ano eh, citizenship Filipino.
Yeah.
Pero ang inyong identity ay
Bangsa Moro po.
Bangsa Moro.
Gaya rin ng indigenous people or Lumads. Mm-hmm. Gaya rin in a lower category, halimbawa Ilocano, Tagalog, Bisaya.
Mm-hmm.
Diba, ganun ho, ganun ho yun. Yung although in a higher category, identity lahat po yun.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So how does it make you feel when you say your nationality is Filipino but your identity is Bangsa Moro?
Because what does that make you those feel? Those are realities. Mm-hmm. We are here in the Philippines and we will remain in the Philippines provided that this government will treat us equally.
Mm-hmm.
And then we feel also gratified that because we are Bangsa Moro, because we have different and distinct narratives.
Mm-hmm.
Our way of life is different. Our custom and tradition is different. Mm-hmm. Our religion is different.
Mm-hmm.
We are in Mindanao. Mm-hmm. And Mindanao has never been part of the Philippines, except when the Americans granted independence in 1946. Even it was against our will, we were lumped together with the Filipinos in the grant of independence in 1946.
Mm-hmm. Mindanao was never part of the Philippines.
It was never a part of the Philippines.
That's another episode.
Hindi
na po kakasya ngayon. Well, anyway, thank you very much, Chairman Iqbal. Thank you so much for agreeing to this interview.
Salamat po.
News.PH will be right back. Stay with us. Welcome back to News.PH. I'm Pia Hontiveros. The Mamasapano clash has turned into a nightmare for the Aquino administration, and much of it has to do with public relations. We spoke yesterday to Greg Garcia, a veteran advertising and public relations man. Here's that interview. Is there a crisis in the Aquino administration?
Yes, I believe there is a crisis.
What kind of a crisis?
It's a big PR crisis. It's equivalent to there's a death in the family. How do you handle it?
Mm-hmm.
So there was a death in the family. How did they handle it? Did they handle it the way the bereaved people want to be responded to? Or were they, in a sense, alienating them the way they acted?
Mm-hmm.
A good example, it's a good parallel. Is what happened in Jordan. They lost a guy who was burned, you know, barbecued. How did they react? They reacted the way people would like you to react,
mm-hmm.
with a bit of fire, with a bit of anger, at the same time consoling you.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was, in life, there's always a hero and a villain.
And a villain.
So you've got to be able to take always the role of a villain, or a hero, and picture the other one as a villain.
Okay.
Once you're a part of the villains, then you have a problem.
Okay. So you're saying here in the Mamasapano issue or the clash, we identified the villain. So we were looking for a hero.
The heroes were the SAF-44. The villains were the MILF. Mm-hmm. No? Now, where did where did the administration people go? How did they handle themselves? Mm-hmm. Were they aligned with the heroes or were they aligned with the villains? Mm-hmm. Did they take action against the villains to satisfy the hero mm-hmm. or what? What, yeah. what was their narrative or their story? How did they handle it? Look at Jordan. The king just said, you know, took on, from a visual point of view, put on a camouflage and said words, you know, until our fuel dies, until our fuel runs out, until our bullet runs out, we will run after you. Mm-hmm. And the jets went, you know. Mm-hmm. I'm not suggesting that he should have gone and kill all the MILF.
Yeah, yeah.
No, what I'm saying, it was the right response, mm-hmm. you know. But here, was it the right response? People were grieving. You have 44 people believed to have been massacred. Mm-hmm. So you want somebody to come in and say, don't worry, I'm your father. Mm-hmm. Nobody is going to get away with it. Mm-hmm. I'll take care of you and I will run after those people mm-hmm. who did this to you. Somebody has to pay.
Okay. Can you tell us, we're going to pick your PR brains now and tell us, and you're in this way you're going to be giving free PR advice.
It's okay, they will take it anyway.
So, free PR advice
sure.
to the palace, no, to the administration. What were the wrong things that were done and what should have happened? For example, you know, if we talk about the welcome ceremonies of Villamor, so let's go item by item. Ano dapat ang ginawa?
Well, it's a textbook solution actually when you think about it. Even si ano canceled everything to be with the Marines, si Obama. What they should have done was the palace should have said, okay, cancel everything, I want to be with these families. Mm-hmm. Whether there will be ceremonies or not, I want to be with them. Mm-hmm. Go there and console them and tell them, I will take care of you and I'm going to make sure that justice will be given to this 44. Mm-hmm. As the commander-in-chief, I will not allow this to go unpunished.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But, you know, the palace explained in two ways. Number one, it wasn't on his schedule. And number two, he went to the necrological services and spoke there to sort of make up for it. Was that making up for things?
The word is make up. Number one, it's bad enough you're making up. Mm-hmm. Second, the makeup was wrong. Mm-hmm. You know, to say that it wasn't on schedule. You cancel your schedule. There's a death in the family. Mm-hmm. You don't, even on a personal note, if your brother dies, you don't say, I cannot go there tonight, eh. Why? I have a party. Committed ko na nung araw pa, eh. You cancel the party. Mm-hmm. You go there, or you go to the wake, and go to the party if you want. Mm-hmm. But I keep on saying, we are not thinking machines who feel. We are feeling machines who think. Mm-hmm. So you gotta go emotions first before the rational basis. Uh-huh.
Okay. So after Villamor and then after, well, he also faced the families one by one in Camp Bagundiwa in Taguig. He faced them again just last week, no?
Yeah.
Did that make up for things?
You see, you have some actions that run contrary to what you say publicly. Mm-hmm. Okay? You go there and say, I will take care of you. But publicly, nobody's running after the alleged assailants. No? Why couldn't say, you, I want the cell phones, I want the personal belongings returned in 7 days. Mm-hmm. It's not hard. Mm-hmm. They can do some back channeling and say, solve nyo na, so we can do something. It's a very nice analogy. Somebody said this. Eh? It's like you're about to get married, mm-hmm. BBL, etc. But you caught your... You caught the bride or the groom nangangaliwa. Mm-hmm. Will you insist on a wedding? No. Liligawan mo ulit yung babae o yung lalaki, di ba? Mm-hmm. Before you even talk about, no,
moving forward.
Kinakasal natin, yeah. Mm-hmm. Before moving forward, you have to woo. There is something the matter. Eh. Mm-hmm. Something is wrong. There's been a death in the family.
Uh-huh. But, you know, the administration explains and says that we need to move forward with the peace talks. We need to sign this agreement so that, well, in so many words, so that there will be no war.
What's wrong?
Is this good handling?
No. What's wrong with, there's a wake, let the wake happen muna. Parang sabi mo rin yung, again, I'm sorry, I have to use this analogy, parang sabi, namatayin, gusto niya pagatian yung will. Hindi, pagatian na natin, may will na yan eh. Mm-hmm. It's in bad days. Mm-hmm. Diba? I mean, okay. Simple, there's a death in the family, let the grief die down mm-hmm. before you even talk about rational things. It's all emotional. Eh? Yeah. Attend to the needs. and make sure they feel that somebody's behind them.
Yeah.
Somebody's going to give them justice.
Yeah, okay. So from a PR mind's
from a
point
human,
of view.
From a humanity point of view.
Yeah, from your humanity.
Not
and
just
PR. Mass, yeah.
PR is basically knowing how to be human. You know?
There you have it.
Yeah.
You said let the grief die down. No? So
sure.
It's been 4 weeks, no?
That's the grief.
Almost a month. And the grief has not...
Because
apparently
been,
there is...
Because the palace has aggravated it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And every time that... They try to explain it, but then the next day, they say something is wrong pala. It's not
uh-huh.
the way it is. For example, just last night, or the other night, they returned the guns, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then last night, they said, the guns we got are unserviceable.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the parts have been changed. Ah, people are in uproar again.
Yeah.
And then there's talk that they will pay to return the guns. Ah, there's uproar again.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You see, sometimes what you say isn't matched by what you do.
Yeah.
They should all be matched. There should be sincerity. If mm-hmm. there's sincerity, everything follows.
Yeah.
If there's no sincerity, then you're all making up along the way. It's excuses.
Mm-hmm.
PR is nothing but being human, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Understanding the human behavior
mm-hmm.
and addressing them as people. You know?
See,
you cannot demand that you do what I want.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I must give you what you want.
Mm-hmm. Isn't there anything that the administration or President Aquino did right since day one?
Nothing. Sorry, it's mm-hmm. really nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But look at all the excuses, like in social media now, it's going viral. Lacerda said, the best way to honor the 44 is to pass the BBL. Hello? It's contradictory.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Why would they say such things? You know?
Yeah.
The best way to honor.
Uh-huh.
You know that no relative, no, the Filipinos are not going to accept that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But it's coming from them. Why are they saying that?
Yeah. You know, a while ago you said, you know, okay, we'll pick, I said, I'll pick your brains for some advice. And you said, well, they won't take it anyway. But here, I'm going to ask you for your advice. If you were going to give advice for the palace today, what is it that can still be done? What is it that...
If I were there, I'd say, you know, the past couple of days, I think we've been goofing.
Mm-hmm.
I think all the pronouncements have been contrary to each other. Let me tell you what I feel inside.
Mm-hmm.
This is what I feel inside. I think, I am sorry. I have been misinformed from day one.
Mm-hmm.
There are things that I knew, there were things they kept from me. That's not going to work. I come here now as a person. I am sorry.
Mm-hmm. Going to work if the president
not
says
not in the tonality of Mrs.
yeah.
Arroyo. No?
Okay.
But, you know, admit that there has been wrong information.
How will he say that? What words will he use apart from I am sorry?
Well, he's good in words. No. Well, first, in his own words, show that he sympathizes and he wishes he could have done better.
Mm-hmm.
But now I want to do the things right, and this is what I'm going to do.
That interview with Greg Garcia continues after this break. News.PH will be right back. Welcome back to News.PH. I'm Pia Hontiveros. Greg Garcia had quite a bit to say about Mamasapano and how the administration handled it, although like he says, the administration probably won't listen to him. But then again, it's interesting to listen to what he has to say.
That's a nice example in advertising history.
Mm-hmm.
There was this telephone company in the States that had really bad, bad service,
mm-hmm.
similar to the bad service of the telephone companies here, or probably worse.
Uh-huh.
They always promise, but they never deliver. Finally, they were going to buy equipment and give good service. So how are they going to deliver that? So they had the advertising. They showed the president of the telephone company and said something like, I am Juan de la Cruz. Boo! Then you heard this booing. Boo, 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 boo. Okay, I know how you feel about me. Boo, boo. I understand, and I'm sorry. I know you're angry at me. I don't blame you. Our service really sucked. Boo, and then the boos became lesser and lesser.
Uh-huh.
And then they were listening. Here's what we've got. Blah, 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 blah. The boos disappeared. He talked. And then in the end, they applauded. Same principle, you know. Let them boo you and face the booing. Say, okay.
Okay.
I'm just a man. I'm not perfect. And that's a problem. The people always, my people in the palace always want to picture me as a god. I am not. And that's why we made the mistakes in those moves. But as a man, I have a clean heart, you know that. I love you guys. Now let me tell you what I really want to do.
Okay.
Hindi ba medyo mag-ano ka?
Yeah, oo. Parang, I think that's doable.
Teka naman, bakit ka naman, ba't mo naman babatuhin itong tao yung nagmagandang loob na?
Yeah.
Kasi yung, this is what we should do. We should sign the BBL.
And what is he going to say now that he's going to do?
Whatever it is they
want to
do.
Whatever it is they want to do.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because they have, their agenda is different from the what people want there. Their agenda is to push the BBL. Mm-hmm. People now are skeptical about it. So there's a mismatch now. Eh.
Uh-huh. So you're saying they can still push the BBL if the president will...
Well, I wouldn't try to push it now.
Yeah. But he must first apologize and first...
He must first say, not apologize and say, no, you know, we didn't do the correct things. Mm-hmm. Okay, I think we should do the correct things. And here's the correct things. I really want to make up for some of the wrong things that we did. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, first, you already get the... You know, when people are booing you and say, here I am, Lumulohod, the booing will stop, you know. Mm-hmm. But if you stop there and fight the booing, they will boo back. Mm-hmm. But they're booing to you and suddenly you have a different way of treating them. Says, okay.
Parang humility.
Sure. Mm-hmm. And then the boo will die down and say, okay, let's start fresh. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because at the root of my heart, naman, you know I'm a good person. Mm-hmm. Okay. Judgment that we have done by the people have been wrong. Mm-hmm. Let's start. Here's what I want to do. First, second, whatever that is.
Okay. And that you think that will solve things? This PR crisis, this will...
It's better than what they're doing now.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You know? Because the issues are, what do you do with the MILF? Mm-hmm. People expect a leader to say, MILF, I trust you, I like you. But hey, this is a game changer. Let's do things right. Mm-hmm. The first thing they want is return all the belongings. That's how you mean. Just return it, okay? Mm-hmm. That is not going to start a war. Mm-hmm. It's so basic, just return. Show goodwill, show some goodness in your heart. Mm-hmm. That's what people are saying, mm-hmm. you know?
Will the public still welcome, if the MILF does something like that, will the public still welcome that in spite of the fact that they returned unserviceable firearms?
That's what I'm saying, starts trying to say, okay, there's the other side, you know, there's the other side about the MILF and about us that you don't know. We want to tell you about it. You know, the past 4 weeks is to me a PR fiasco. Mm-hmm. Everybody in the palace just wanted to protect me. It's a fiasco. So let's throw away the PR and just do things the way it should be done. Okay? Mm-hmm. I talked to MILF, said, stop now this PR. Let's do what is correct, even though it's against our principle. Let's just do it because we all made a mistake. Mm-hmm. Okay?
So parang take the bull by the horns and just address the issues.
Sure. Directly. Sure. Mm-hmm. And then what else will they tell you? I mean, you've appeased them, you know.
Yeah.
You've given them a bit of blood versus not giving them anything. Mm-hmm. Versus fighting them, you know, mm-hmm. and saying, no, tuloy natin to.
Yeah.
You've got to soften the heart. I mean, it's human nature. It doesn't take PR or a genius.
Yeah.
But that's how to turn it around. Okay. I think you turn it around.
Yeah.
You know? Magpakumbaba ka and say, ay, mali kami.
Mm-hmm.
Maling-mali. Hindi kami yung mali, kundi yung mga ginawa naming steps, mali.
Mm-hmm. At inaamin ko.
Inaamin mali yung aming mga moves too. Because may mga experts kami sa propaganda. Mali lahat yun. Tama na. Di na ako makikinig doon. Mm-hmm. Mula ngayon, everything I do from the heart. Mm-hmm. Okay? From the heart, this is what I want to do. Mm-hmm. Number one, I want to do this. Number two, I want to do this. Against the wishes of Dallas and etc., hell, I want to do this.
Okay.
Diba? Against the whatever the negotiating panel wants, I'm saying, paika muna tayo. Let's do first what's right. Mm-hmm. And then let's go and talk about it. In the meantime, let's do this first.
Yeah, okay. No? You said from the heart, no? Many times during this whole scenario, the president would mention his parents, his father's sacrifice, his mother having been at the forefront of the battle to win this war for democracy, etc. Didn't that work? Wasn't that an appeal to the heart? Why?
Isa pa yun eh. I think, kumbaga sa sine, bubuk sarado na yung how great my parents were, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Tama na yun, people na totoo ready eh. Mm-hmm. You're on your own.
Mm-hmm.
Never mind your parents, you know. We already have them in the paper bill.
Yeah.
So we already always honor them twice a year, you know.
Uh-huh.
Stop, you know.
Okay.
You're different, you know.
Okay, apart from a public address like that, no, where you're suggesting...
What naman yun? Public address, yeah. And talaga naman sincere moves.
Oh, sincere moves. How should the president face the families again? Or hindi na?
Hindi na. He's faced them enough. Mm-hmm. And some of them are, you know, the one I'm meeting, maybe. And some of them are being, maybe, paid to say wrong things. No, who knows? Mm-hmm. There are two sides playing, using the family naman eh.
Yeah.
So, okay. What for? Just do what... Not the 44 families represent a bigger segment of the Filipinos. Eh. And you can more or less read the sentiments of the rest of people there. Eh, and just address it, you know, say,
yeah.
We did not make the mistake from my heart. My mistake is listening to the wrong moves to take after this. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
There are things I want to do, but there's this so-called, you have to weigh it against this. I'm saying, screw it. Let me just do what I think I want to do.
Yeah.
It may be right, it might be wrong. This is what I want to do because I think it's right, number one. I think it's right that those people who massacred them should answer for it. MILF and we should sit down and see what is the best mechanics. No, let us not defend each other. There must be a mechanic, but some people should pay. Okay? Number two, hey, I know it's against the system or your culture, but those are not your phones. Those are not your wallets. Those are not your clothes. Those are not your properties. Return whatever they have, mm-hmm. you know.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, these 44 and those who survive, they must be compensated. Financially, morally, psychologically, and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
BIL is under question now. Let's have a fresh dialogue with the people who oppose it and see what we can do to make it happen.
Mm-hmm.
It's still a quest for peace. What is wrong is the process.
Mm.
The objectives have always been right. What I want to do has always been right. The way I handled it, the process, it's been wrong. Wrong process for the past 4 weeks. Mm. I'm sorry. Let's do it.
Okay. This is what you hope he will do and the administration will do. If they don't do this and then, you know, just move forward on the path that they are already taking.
Then there will be your side, our side, their side. This should be a period of mourning and stop it, and then we can go back. During the period of mourning, that's when you send flowers.
Mm-hmm.
That's when you send food. That's when you go and makikiramika. You know, not discuss first the will,
mm-hmm.
the division, you know.
Yeah.
And just say it from your heart. Stop listening to all the PR non-experts in the palace.
Oh.
You know.
PR
just,
non-experts?
Yeah, the PR non-experts. Ang gusto lang din naman na pabangon ng papel sa presidente.
Wait, if they don't do this, if they don't follow your advice.
If they don't follow this thought, it's not advice, it's a thought.
Thought.
Then how will you win the hearts of people? Mm-hmm. It's a courtship again. You've got to win the people. You've lost a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
Win them back.
Yeah.
By listening to their heart.
Uh-huh. Well, there's a year and 4 months to go before he steps down. What are we looking at?
What do you mean?
What kind of a presidency are we looking at?
Well, the presidency that started with him. When people love him because he doesn't have lies in his heart.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a strong moral compass. Bring it back. Just make sure that people never forget. It's always been there.
Mm-hmm.
It's the actions that have been wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But the real me has always been there. It hasn't changed. Mm-hmm. The moves that we took to try to correct this mess or try to placate you, that was what was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
The process.
Is it correct to say Mamasapano changed the landscape for 2016?
To a certain extent, I don't know if it's transient, but in terms of emotions,
mm-hmm.
okay, people, the emotions of people have changed. Suddenly, they're scrutinizing the BBL. Nobody cared about the BBL before.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody talked about the details. Now, everybody's looking at the details. You know?
Mm-hmm.
So, and everybody's discovering a lot of things. So, it's time to court the people again with the BBL concept. People are after peace anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's against peace. They just don't understand how the principal players are suddenly villains pala. You have to tell them, no, they're not villains. They just look like villains. But deep in their hearts, they're heroes. They are heroes.
Uh-huh. You know? Okay. How will this change 2016 and possible candidates for president?
It may have changed. They might be looking for somebody stronger than the kind of stuff that the president is showing now.
Mm-hmm.
They might want somebody who's sterner and who's got, you know, more balls, as they say.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Final words?
good luck.
Good luck to?
Good luck to them.
Good luck to
it's
them.
Probably, they probably are ignoring us right now and laughing at us.
Really, seriously?
Seriously.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching. See you again next Wednesday. I'm Pia Hontiveros. Good night.